Hello children, how are you? In this lesson, we are going to see uses of water, okay? That is importance of water, okay children? So let us continue. Now today's topic is importance of hydrosphere, okay children? So what is the uses of water and why we are using water? For what reason we are using waters? Is it importance to use water for us, okay, to survive in this world? Let us see. Okay, so now we need water, okay, to carry out many activities in our daily lives. Is it true or not, children? Is it true? 100%, okay, because we need water. We cannot survive without water. Okay, water is precious for us. It's very, very important for human being as well as to animal, plants also, because they also need to survive in this world, isn't it? So we need water to drink, to take bath, cook food, okay, etc. Animals and plants too also need water, okay, for their survival. Correct. If there is no water, it cannot evaporate and form clouds. Okay, if there is no water, water cannot change to water vapor and it cannot evaporate. If it is not evaporate, means there is no cloud. If there is no clouds, then there will not be any rain. If there is no rain, animals cannot survive. At the same time, plants also. If there is no plants, what we have to eat? There is nothing to eat for us. We need water, isn't it? Water only we can able to survive in this world. So water is very precious for us. So just imagine, just 3% of water we are able to live, okay? So you should not waste water, isn't it? So here, just look at here, lake, okay? So you know the definition of the lake, children. Lake is a large area of water surrounded by land, which is known as lake, okay? So this is the picture of lake. And now here, there is a pond. What is pond? Pond is an area filled with water, either natural or artificial, that is smaller than a lake. Okay, okay. Stream is actually a small narrow river. Okay, very small narrow river, isn't it? And river, do you know river? River actually a large natural stream of water flowing in a channel to the sea, a lake or another river. Look over here, children. See, the river is flowing in the channels. Okay, so look, one channel, this is the second channel, this is the third channel. So river can flow in their channels, isn't it? They can flow number of channels. So these water bodies are very important for
us. We call water as an important resource as we use it for various purposes. And we can divide this into three different uses, like agricultural use, domestic use, and industrial use. We all know that crops require water for their growth, and we provide this water to our fields by proper irrigation facilities. Talking about the domestic use, it simply implies water which is required for household purposes, like drinking, washing, cooking, watering plants, etc. This water reaches to our homes through various distribution systems. And talking about industries, they require a huge amount of water at various levels of operations. Friends, we saw here that water has many different uses, but does all this water get exhausted as we use it? If that is the case, then how is this percentage of water on the earth maintained? Water is replenished or recycled through a natural process. which is called water cycle.